Hello friends, welcome to the introduction video on National Certification Examination for Energy Managers and Energy Auditors conducted under the aegis of Bureau of Energy Efficiency. My name is Suresh Gujar. I am a BE Certified Energy Auditor. I have done BTech and MTech dual degree in Electrical Engineering from NIT Rourkela, including Master's courses from Tallinn University of Technology. As a BE Certified Energy Auditor, I have a rich experience in conducting energy audit in diverse industries including thermal power plant, iron and steel, fertilizer plant, mines and distribution companies. Before moving to the examination detail, let's first look into the importance of energy efficiency. Energy efficiency is a linchpin in addressing the global challenges such as climate change, resource depletion, economic stability. Strategies that enable the organizations to use less energy are the easiest, lowest investment, and often the simplest approaches to reduce the carbon emission. Prioritizing energy efficiency not only benefits the environment, but also has far-reaching implications for societal well-being, economic prosperity, and international cooperation. With increasing awareness of climate change and the need for sustainable practices, there is a growing emphasis on energy conservation. Certified energy managers and auditors play a crucial role in implementing the energy efficient solutions and strategies across various sectors. Now let's dwell into the pivotal role played by certified energy managers and auditors. Energy managers occupies an important position as he is the focal point of all the activities pertaining to the energy management in an organization. As per the provisions of Environment Conservation Act 2001, it is mandatory for the designated consumer, that is energy intensive sectors, to designate or appoint an energy manager under the clause 14L. The certified energy manager provides a leadership in the formulation of corporate energy policy and the development of energy management action plan. Responsibilities of certified energy auditor include to carry out the detailed energy audit, perform efficiency evaluation of utilities, and then identify, prioritize, and recommend the energy saving measures to the organization. Now that we have understood the significance and pivotal role of energy auditor, let's explore the prospectus of the certification. Attaining the certified energy manager and auditor certification not only establishes your standing as a proficient energy professional, but also propels your career forward. This certification brings about industry and peer recognition, highlighting your expertise in energy auditing principles, practices, and technologies. Moreover, it elevates professional benchmark, both technical prowess and ethical consideration as an energy manager in the designated consumer. In pursuit of this objective, the national level certification examination aims to establish a uniform criteria for the certification of energy managers and auditors. This initiative ensures that industry can readily access the services of qualified individual equipped with the requisite knowledge and skill in the field. We at Accelerate Minds extend a warm welcome to all the professionals. Explore our thoughtfully designed online module, Energy Audit Essentials, strategically crafted with the primary focus on aligning with the BE's National Certification Examination. Our aim is to ensure that this module effectively prepares you for the success in the certification process. Now, coming to the question, why should you subscribe to our course? Unlock your potential with our course, a blend of expertise and efficiency. Welcome to the Energy Audit Essential course, where excellence meets efficiency. Meticulously crafted and designed by qualified energy auditors and engineers from the premier institutes such as IIT, NIT, and prestigious IIM. Subscribing to our course is the key to unlocking your success in BE certification examination, and here's why. Every aspect of the course has been developed with utmost diligence. Number 1. Time-efficient learning. Our course is thoughtfully structured to fit into the busy schedule of industry professional without compromising on the depth of learning. The mission behind our curriculum is simple: minimum efforts, maximum outcome. Number 2. Effective learning tools. A. Self-explanatory and well-organized content. B. Scripts and engaging presentation, which can be downloaded for the future references. Number 3. Flexible learning path. offering flexibility in learning paths such as self-paced modules, accommodates professional with the different learning speed and preferences. Number 4. Dedicated Q&A discussion section to post queries, share insights, and foster a collaborative learning environment. Number 5. Regular assessments and quizzes at the end of the chapter provide the participants with tangible measure of their progress. Upon successful completion of the course, participants will be awarded a certificate validating completion of the course. Join us on this enriching journey where your success is our priority. Now let's discuss who should enroll this course. Number 1. Professional appearing for this upcoming 24th National Certification Examination. Number 2. Engineers working in designated consumers, industries and state designated agencies, that is SDAs. Number 3. Energy consultants looking to enhance their expertise in the field of energy management. Number 4. Energy professionals working in educational institutions and universities. Number 5. Students aiming to deepen their understanding and skill in the field of energy management and energy audits. Now moving to the eligibility criteria and pattern of the exam. Candidates appearing for the Energy Manager Certification exam shall possess any one of the following qualifications. Number 1. Graduate engineer or architect with 3 years of experience involving the use of energy in operations, maintenance, planning, energy management, energy efficiency, and energy conservation, building designs, or building the energy management. Number 2. Postgraduate in engineering, architecture with 2 years of relevant experience. Number 3. Graduate engineer or architect with postgraduate degree in management and 2 years of relevant work experience. Number 4. Diploma engineers or equivalent with 6 years of experience. Number 5. Postgraduate in physics, electronics, chemistry with physics and mathematics at graduation level with 3 years of relevant experience. Candidates appearing for Energy Auditor Certification Examination shall possess any one of the following qualifications. Number 1. Graduate engineer or architect with 3 years of relevant work experience. Number 2. Postgraduate in engineering, architecture with 2 years of relevant work experience. Number 3. Graduate engineers and architects with PG degree in management and 2 years of relevant work experience. That is, diploma engineers and postgraduate in physics, electronics and chemistry are eligible for certified energy managers exam but not for the certified energy auditor exam. Regarding the maximum attempts and the supplementary exam, a newly registered candidate is required to pass the examination by appearing in a maximum of 3 attempts per paper within the 6 consecutive exams. The candidate, however, has the option to apply and register himself or herself as a fresh candidate. A candidate is declared to be passed if he secures minimum of 50 marks in each paper. Upgradation from Energy Manager to Energy Auditor is only applicable for Energy Manager registered candidates. The certificate issued to the successful candidate is valid for a period of 5 years. And renewable after every 5 years after attending a short-term fresher course. Now let's understand the examination scheme. The certification examination will be conducted based on the syllabus approved by the Bureau, that is based on the 4 guidebooks of the 4th edition. They are available for download on the link provided here. The national examination will be conducted in English medium only. Paper 1, 2 and 3 are common for both Energy Manager and Energy Auditor, and they consist of both objectives and descriptive based questions. Paper 4 for the Energy Auditor is an open book examination and consists of descriptive and numerical based questions. The degree of difficulty of paper 4 will be comparatively higher as compared to the other papers. The 4 papers are as follows. Paper 1, General Aspects of Energy Management and Energy Audit, which will be of duration 3 hours and a maximum mark of 150 marks. Passing mark is 50% of that, that is 75 marks. Paper 2 is Energy Efficiency in Thermal Utilities. Duration is same as paper 1. Paper 3 is Energy Efficiency in Electrical Utilities. It is also of 3 hours and maximum marks is 150 marks. Paper 4, Energy Performance Assessment for Equipments and Utility Systems, which is open book based examination. The duration of exam is 2 hours and the maximum marks is 100, passing mark is 50 marks. Let's now look at the syllabus, that is topics covered in the 4 guidebooks one by one. Paper 1, General Aspects of Energy Management and Energy Audit. Chapter 1 is Energy Scenario. Chapter 2, Energy Conservation Act and Related Policies. Chapter 3, Basics of Energy and its Various Form. Chapter 4, Energy Management and Audit. Chapter 3, Material and Energy Balance. Chapter 6, Energy Action Planning. Chapter 7, Financial Management. Chapter 8, Project Management. Chapter 9, Energy Monitoring and Targeting. Chapter 4, Energy, Environment and Climate Change. Chapter 11, New and Renewable Energy Sources. Now moving to the book number 2, that is Energy Efficiency in Thermal Utilities. First chapter is Fuel, second Boiler, third is Steam Systems, fourth is Furnaces, fifth is Insulation and Refractories, sixth is FBC Boilers, seventh Cogeneration, eighth is Waste Heat Recovery, ninth is Heat Exchangers. Book number 3, that is Energy Efficiency in Electrical Utilities. Chapter number 1, Electrical System. Number 2, Electrical Motors. Number 3, Compressed Air Systems. Chapter 4 is HVAC and Refrigeration System. Chapter 5 is Fan and Blowers. 6th is Pump and Pumping Systems. 7th chapter is Cooling Tower. 8th is Electrical Lighting System. 9th is Diesel and Natural Gas Power Generating Systems. 10th is Energy Conservation in Building and ECBC. Now coming to the book number 4, that is Energy Performance Assessment for Equipment and Utility System. Most of the content is based on the previous 3 books, and this paper consists of numerical based questions, which will be of consist of 20 marks questions also. In this, the strategy is to solve as much as questions as possible. We'll see the chapters which are included in this book. Chapter number 1, Boiler. Chapter number 2, Furnaces. Chapter number 3, Cogeneration Turbine, Gas and Steam. Chapter number 4, Heat Exchanger. Chapter number 5 is Electrical Motor and Variable Speed Drive. Chapter number 6 is Fan and Blowers. Chapter number 7, Water Pumps. 8th is Compressors. Chapter 9 is HVAC Systems. 10, Performing Financial Analysis. From 11th chapter, we have energy performance in different plants such as power plant, iron and steel industry, cement and textile industry, the performance assessment in building, and then textile industries. The level of the 4th paper exam is a bit higher as compared to the previous 3 exams. We'll conclude the presentation with the fee structure of the exam. A. For new candidates, following is the application fee. For general and OBC, it is 500. SC/ST candidates is 250 rupees. For OBC, it's 250 rupees. And if it per candidate is company sponsored, the application fee is 500 rupees. Second is certification fee, including the examination fee. For general and OBC creamy layer candidate, it's 10,000. And for SC/ST, it is 5,000 rupees. For OBC non-creamy layer, it is 5,000 rupees. And if the candidate is company sponsored, the certification fee is 20,000 rupees. Next is for supplementary candidates who appears for the paper again. This time application fee is nil, but you have to pay the certification fee and examination fee for each paper. For general and OBC, it is 1500 rupees per paper. For STSC, it is 750 rupees per paper. And for OBC non-creamy, it is 750 rupees per paper. Next is, if you want to upgrade your certification from energy manager to energy auditor, the application fee is nil, but you have to pay the certification fee including the examination fee. For general and OBC, it is 1500 rupees. For SC/ST, it is 750 rupees. For OBC non-creamy layer candidate, it is 750 rupees. Candidates who are sponsored by the state designated agencies, they have to register online similar to the other candidates and have to upload the necessary documents. The payment refunds will be initiated on verification of authenticity of the uploaded enclosures. With this, I have covered most of the important information related to BE National Certification Examination. I once again extend a warm welcome to all of you to our course Energy Audit Essentials, specifically designed for the success in this examination. For additional information and inquiries, please feel free to visit our website, that is www.acceleratemindsmindset.com. If you have any queries, you can also mail your queries at the info@acceleratemindsmindset.com. Thank you for watching the video.